Now that there's a restraining order, restraining, he says, all judicial persons who are supposed to swear him in. How come Uchioga says he'll be sworn in today?
Well, I know that that order, somebody has even pointed to the fact that that order, there are so many irregularities in that order. I mean, in terms of whether it was even filed in the registry. I don't even think there was a process, because the chief judge is said to be in hiding. And so who assigned the case to the judge, you know, Sisioma? So many things, you know, but I think at the end of the day, NJC may likely come in. There are a lot of things that will happen in this case that will be decided by the judiciary at the end of the day. And so people who are doing certain things now must be very careful, because at the end of the day, everyone must account. And day of accounting is coming in Abia. So I think that order is clearly invalid. It was even, I told you, based on Section 143. Section 143 is applicable. We have lawyers. Let them read Section 143. It's only applicable to judgment given by the tribunal. It defines who a tribunal and court is, and not judgment given by in pre-election matter. And so you cannot base upon 143 and say, I'm restraining the chief judge. And no, that was an improper order in the first place. But it was based upon wrong law. Yes.
But the procedure for invalidating that one is that you have to go to court.
No, we have it vacated.
Means you can't be sworn in today.
Well, I can't say that. I can't say that, you know.
Can you be vacated today?
I can't say that. But I know that the legal team are clearly on it. The legal team are clearly on it. They will look at the order and know what to do appropriately.
Some people say that there was no order for the withdrawal of Mr. Ekpeazu's certificate of return.
When you are asked to issue, as I said earlier, it's an administrative thing, it means that the other one is cancelled. It's administrative, it doesn't have to be another. If you say issue this person, it then means that the man that is here ought not to have what he has. And so it goes without saying. It doesn't require any further interpretation. When a pronouncement is very unambiguous and very clear, you don't resort to any other mode of interpretation.
So how does your team intend to proceed? I mean, right now, the court on holiday.
Well, it's also very doubtful whether he can make such an order, because for now, he is not the sitting governor. Based upon the judgment, based upon what has happened, that his own certificate has been cancelled, can he validly in law? Because all these things will be tested in court. Or what he has done by declaring, you know, Monday and Friday, Friday and Monday public holiday, for the death of Ojo Maduko, who wasn't a governor of the state, who wasn't a public servant of Abia State, but was a federal district. So he's not being buried. So if he declared 2 days for his to mourn him, then it means that when you bury him, you may declare 1 year. Or if any of the governors that were there now, you know, dies, then they will declare maybe 2 years for them, because they are the governors of the state. You are declaring 2 days just to mourn, you know, somebody who wasn't a governor of the state. So there is something fishy about it. They want to frustrate the order. That's the point. And judges are all watching. Nigerians are all watching that. This is a clear intention to frustrate the judgment of the Federal High Court.
Let's also get your perspective on this other view.
As we speak now, Governor Ekpeazu is the governor of Abia State. Let everybody be objective, and let's protect this democracy as much as we can. Because to the best of my knowledge as well, Mr. Oga has not been sworn in. We only have one oath of office and oath of allegiance to the Constitution. It was sworn to by Governor Ekpeazu a few months ago. So Mr. Oga has not been sworn in. So how can he assume the seat of governor of Abia State? The governor, and there cannot be two governors of a state, only one governor, as provided for in the Constitution. So Governor Ekpeazu is the governor of Abia State as we speak, by operation of law.
Is that the case?
By the same operation of the law, that certificate has been withdrawn. By the same operation of the law.
So who's the governor?
And there was a court order ordering him to vacate. You know, there is, as I said earlier, there was an extant court order which has not been reversed.
So is there
it's
a
very,
vacuum?
Very important.
Is there a vacuum?
Well, I won't stay here and say that it's a vacuum for now, because there's supposed to be somebody that's supposed to be there based upon the judgment that has not been reversed. It's important we point out this. That judgment has not been reversed by any higher court. It's only the same court that can stay that order or Court of Appeal. Now, in the absence of any staying order, in the absence of reversal of that judgment, then the person that has been declared to be the governor ought to be. But there is seemingly confusion in the sense of that particular black market injunction that was obtained in somewhere in Osisoma, asking the chief judge not to swear him in. That is only thing that has created a confusion. But as I said earlier, it is an invalid order.
was not made validly. It was not made in accordance with the law. He quoted the wrong section of the law. And I said that particular order would be vacated.
I think it looks like the only way to sort this out would have been with the tax board coming into this. Definitely, if you work in an establishment, you just wouldn't have the faintest of idea of what is being deducted, whether they have really captured it properly or not.
Okay. So if you now admit, you know, that it's a documentary thing that, oh, yes, there was mistake on the face of the document, but it's not by us. And according to the lawyer that came here, Aham Job, he said that they filed a paper, that is a Board of Internal Revenue, saying that what they issued was correct. Is it not? And then looking at what is issued on the face of it is not correct. They mean that you're not qualified. Even if for the fact that they say that it's correct does not make it correct. What makes a document correct is that looking at it on the face, what you say this is what it is not what. I've given you an instance where a person has letter of employment and the letter shows when he started employment, and then you now declare that he start paying tax when he was not employed. I've also given you issue of his taxable income. He gave a figure different from, because it's deductible at source. So if this thing is actually deductible at source, why would we now give wrong information? If every month you deduct his tax. So what you should give now will be something that is accurate. More so, you, this declarant, has said that whatever information I've submitted is accurate and completely without any equivocation. And that if it's found to be false, I, so person should be disqualified. And it is found on the face of it to be false.
Will pay slips have worked here? I mean, for instance, if he tendered his pay slips and say, well, according to what I know, and looking at my own pay slips, my tax deductions were correct. Maybe the mistake was actually from the tax office.
Beautiful, beautiful argument. If you had done that in his documentary evidence, of course, the court will now believe that it was actually the Board of Internal Revenue that made that mistake. They had that opportunity. Because we filed and said, these things were false on the face of it. So what he should have done is bring all his documents or whatever payslip or whatever information that has been given, how he was paying tax and all that, say, this is what I know that I paid. It is these people that made this mistake, not me. But that was not given. They admitted that it was a mistake, but failed to, you know, address it.
But then you said the case is going to go all the way up to the Supreme Court.
I assume so. Whichever way it goes, the Supreme Court has a final say on this. And they say something.
There's still a window.
There's still a window to Supreme
for
Court.
For all of those matters to come.
Oh, of course, the Supreme Court will look at it. Looking at the document, now it has formed part of records. No evidence again will be taken. What will be looked at is on the face of the document. What you presented even in your defense. What is your defense? They admitted on the face that what they have, what they also saw was a mistake.
Would it be tenable?
So that was admission.
Would it be tenable if he argues that, look, I've not even seen this judgment, so-called, I've not been served, so why should the judgment be binding on me?
Who said that?
I said if. Abia Governor Ikpazu says
that. Who said that? His lawyers were in court. They told him. They were recording the dog. In fact, that's why they were able to file the appeal the following day. Because they got, you know, wind of all the facts, all the ratio.
I'm talking about this latest one.
Which one?
The one that INEC, I beg your pardon, that the court tells INEC immediately get this.
No, what we did is that on the enrollment order was served on all the agencies that are supposed to carry. It was not, you know, let me say, it was served on him, you know, the enrollment order.
But you didn't say if there's a vacuum in Abia State now.
You want me to say whether there's a vacuum? I would say, well, two governors are claiming to be on the seat. That is, I mean, even the papers recognize that there are two governors now in Abia State.
The papers are not the law.
No, the point is that in the eyes of the law.
I really wonder what your client is on the other side.
Yes. So say it again.
I said, I really wonder what you've been saying when your client is on
the
other side.
No, now, it is for you now to judge whether what I've said here in this morning is very logical, very legal, and very constitutional. Now, if I defend my client based upon wrong premise and law, of course, you also know. Nigerians will judge whether what I've said here, based upon what my colleague has said earlier, and what I've just now, is, you know, because I came here with documents.
Okay.
He said,
so let's leave it for Nigerians.
If I gave false information, I should be disqualified. I wanted to say a bit about Abia. I want peace in Abia. It's my state. I'm paying attention to it. I want peace, and I want peace to reign.
All right. Well, anchor on that point, Onyekachi Ubani is a legal practitioner, former MBA chair, Ikeja Chapter. Well, that's the show today. Thank you all for watching. I'm Chamberlain Oso.
And it's Friday I'm not supposed to leak that 21st anniversary and all of that. But thank you for watching. Maokwe Umu.
Anyway, she was going to say there's going to be a party. Anyway, I just said there's going to be a party anyway. Congratulations to Channels Television, to all those that started this whole dream, those that are no more, God bless their souls. Mm. And for those that are still here, well, good work. And for those to come on, a great one. Many thanks for watching. I'm Sulaiman.